路透社在3月16号的时候独家报道 Elon Musk 他旗下的 SpaceX， 当时刚开始的时候很多人以为说他只是带着你可能到火星去，可能带着你的骨灰到太空里头去，可能带你去太空旅游，你完全搞错了。事实上它作为一个低轨卫星，它是最好的通讯系统，它在战争的时刻是最好的侦测系统。根据路透社3月16号的报道，美国国家侦察局正和 SpaceX 签订了一个机密合同，这个机密合同呢将打造一个功能强大的新型的间谍系统，由数百颗的卫星组成，对于整个地球呢全部包围，没有人可以有所遁形，每一个国家的军队的移动各种情况都完全是在它的侦测范围里头，在低轨道上以蜂群像蜜蜂一样的方式完全布满整个地球，这是美国对于未来战争维持它的整个最重要的军事能力里头最大的一步，很重要的一个举措。
3, 2, 1, 0 ignition。
SpaceX is ramping up the pace of rocket launches in order to conquer the internet from space. The company has launched more than 1,000 satellites to build a network called Starlink, aimed at bringing faster connections to billions of people.
Satellite internet is really seen to be, you know, an extension of a lot of the terrestrial internet services.
The satellite internet market is expected to be worth more than $400 billion by 2040.
The world seems to have an insatiable appetite for bandwidth.
And this competition is taking place in an area known as low Earth orbit.
It's first come, first serve. So they are racing to occupy those orbital slots because the ones that get there first with the capability of presence is going to be able to set the rules.
And that comes with privacy and security concerns. Still, SpaceX is moving ahead with a larger fleet of satellites, while the relative newcomer China is betting on faster speeds to build a powerful internet network in space.
美中之间的争霸战已经离开地球表面，延烧到外太空，而游走在两大强权间的宠儿埃隆·马斯克忽然被卷入战争漩涡。
Just how closely is U.S. intelligence working with the second wealthiest man in the world? Well, Reuters is now citing a handful of sources who say Elon Musk's space company SpaceX is building a network of spy satellites in a deal worth $1.8 billion. Now, Reuters reports that SpaceX signed that deal with the National Reconnaissance Office in 2021.
路透社称，这显示了这家公司参与美国情报和军事项目的程度，并表明美国防部对旨在支持地面部队的大型近地轨道卫星系统进行了更深入的投资。消息人士表示，该网络建成后将大大提高美国政府和军方在全球快速发现潜在目标的能力。
Chinese state media on Sunday criticized the United States, saying that it is threatening global security. A social media account of the People's Liberation Army said that the SpaceX program reveals shamelessness and double standards of the US.
中方历来主张和平利用太空，积极推动太空国际合作，坚决反对太空武器化和太空军备竞赛。
今年二月，《华尔街日报》就曾披露 SpaceX 与一个不知名的情报机构签订了价值$18亿的星盾机密合约，但没有详细说明该计划目的。如今路透社首次披露 SpaceX 的合约是有关一种功能强大的新型间谍系统。该系统拥有数百颗具有地球成像能力的卫星，能在低轨道上成群运行。而与马斯克的公司展开合作的间谍机构就是美国国家侦察局。
In response to the Reuters story, the NRO acknowledged its mission to develop space-based surveillance systems, but it declined to comment on the extent of SpaceX's involvement. The world's largest satellite operator also didn't respond to several requests for comment about the contract.
美国国家侦察局一位发言人不讳言，该局正在开发世界上有史以来最强大、最多样化、最具弹性的天基情报、监视和侦察系统。
I've always loved using the latest technology. Now, I'm operating the world's most sophisticated satellites. They're orbiting our planet in space, delivering critical intelligence for our troops on the ground, all the way up to the White House. My love of technology is now my career.And I'm making the world a safer place.
消息人士说，原则上这将使美国政府能够快速捕捉几乎全球任何地方地面活动的连续图像，以帮助情报和军事行动。 其中三名消息人士说，从2020年以来，在 SpaceX 猎鹰9号火箭发射的其他卫星中，已经发射了大约十几颗原型卫星。
When I saw this over the weekend, and this broke Saturday morning, and I was like, oh my gosh, is he the most untouchable man in America right now? I mean, when you look at his involvement.
I don't know how you define untouchable, but he's got a lot of secrets. He got a lot of secrets and a lot of power, and the federal government has given him that power because he does it better than the federal government.
SpaceX 长期与美国军方和情报机构密切合作。马斯克的星链系统也在俄乌战争爆发后不久被部署在了乌克兰，为乌军行动做出贡献。此后 SpaceX 宣布针对国家安全和军事部门推出新一代星盾系统，显示星链向军事化迈出了关键一步。
That Musk's influence within the U.S. government is widespread, and that over the last two decades, quote, Musk has sought out business opportunities in crucial areas where, after decades of privatization, the state has receded. The government is now reliant on him, but struggles to respond to his risk-taking, brinkmanship, and caprice.
《华尔街日报》指出，人们对 SpaceX 的星盾部门知之甚少。该部门是专为政府客户设立的，领导层中有一位是前美国空军将领。2023年8月，星盾获得了美国军方一份价值7000万美元的合约，为五角大厦的数十个合作伙伴提供通信服务。不过，星盾的运作基本上不为公众所知。纽约客的一份调查报道，马斯克的影子统治指出，美国政府如今在许多领域都深深仰赖马斯克。可是，美国政府让他拥有这么大的权力，却没有太多制衡机制。
The one problem, of course, which is hinted in your question, is are you devolving the key part of your defense to the discretion, let's say, of a company, an oligarch's company?That's a really difficult question for a lot of defense analysts now.
路透社报道说，星盾的目标是提高美国抵御来自复杂太空力量攻击的能力。此前，五角大厦已对俄罗斯的太空武器威胁发出过警告说，这些威胁可能会使整个卫星网络瘫痪，尤其还要面对来自中国自建的卫星群。
China says its 6G plan is an extension of its 5G network, which has already been rolled out in many Chinese cities. This technological progression is starting to help transform the country's economy.
If you have 6G, your ability to have automation is going to improve exponentially. We mean better manufacturing, we mean better 3D printing, we mean better self-driving cars.
Namrata Goswami is an independent researcher who's been studying global space policy for more than 20 years. And she says China's 6G satellite network could make a big impact once it's up and running.
Once you become the first country to do it, you set the global standards, you set the rules in terms of how this is going to be regulated. Those who are first there will be able to standardize the procedures of that particular market. And then you also set the innovation cycle in technology.
美中之间这场太空争霸战短时间内方兴未艾。